Welcome to the Michael Kouly podcast on rethinking leadership. In these episodes, we will look at leadership with a fresh perspective and take your leadership effectiveness to the next level. For more information, go to kouliinstitute.com and follow Michael's continuous learning insights on social media.
I think you can see acts of leadership in every street. I'll tell you why. Because street is reality. You see, I'm going to use two metaphors now that can be seen as opposites. Huh? They're not really opposite, but you'll get what I'm saying. There's the ivory tower and there's the street. The ivory tower, that's a metaphor for people who are living in a bubble that is maybe constructed from thoughts and thinking, and it's confined to few, conceptual in many ways. But there's also the street where the reality is happening. Where reality is happening. It's like the difference between theory and practice. So you can't go to any street where there's no leadership. Street is reality. Street is the theater of survival. Streets are the theater of opportunities. From the streets of Tehran to the streets of India, to the streets of Manhattan, to the streets of London, to the streets of Cairo, to the streets of Beirut, you name it. These are theaters of survival and of growth, because it's like a small jungle, not in a negative way. You know, when you go to jungle, to a jungle where wild, you know, animals live, this is as far as reality can go. You can't create your own rules. Jungle is jungle. That's the rule of life there. You don't know how to maneuver yourself, you get eaten. So you can't take rules to the jungle. At least if it's a big jungle, otherwise it becomes a zoo. Street is the same thing. Streets are the same thing. They have their own rules, and it's the rules of reality. If you don't know how to survive in the street, then street, you will disappear, because there's no mercy. Street will crush you, because this is where things happen. So that's what's important about streets. If you can make it in the street, then you can make it everywhere. Like they say, if you make it in New York, they can make it anywhere. Because what's in New York? It's the street culture, at least in terms of culture. And even if you go to, you know, if you're even in the office in major corporate companies, it's also a street culture because of the competition. Sharks inside the water and sharks outside the water. Not in a negative way, but in terms of the intensity of competition. So you have to have these instincts alive so that you can survive, and so that you can create opportunities or capture opportunities. And it's full of smart people like you, most probably even smarter than you. Have more drive, have more energy, have more experiences, maybe more courage, more hunger within them, bigger dreams, you know. All of these are around you, and they're all on the same race. So you either be crushed or you learn from them. There is so much that you can learn about leadership from being in the streets or being street smart. So much. I'll name few. To survive and grow, meaning to survive and capture opportunities in the street, you need to be aware of your surrounding. Leadership is the same thing. You can't exercise leadership if you're not aware of your surrounding, if you're not in touch with your reality, if you don't read your reality in an accurate way. You can't live in illusions. Street is not a dream. Leadership is not a dream. It's reality. And it's a difficult and harsh and messy and complicated reality, sometimes violent, full of conflict. So being street smart requires that you're aware of your surrounding, your environment. And that's exactly what you need to do when you exercise leadership. Otherwise, you will suffer and you will fail. So when you're in the street, you need to project self-confidence. The street has no mercy. You've seen a movie where somebody is walking in the street and they're like people standing on the corner of the street, and if they look at his eyes or her eyes and they see lack of confidence, then it's like an invitation, come and attack me or rob me. So you cannot afford in the street not to show confidence, not to show that you can take care of yourself, you can defend yourself. Because hesitation and weakness in the street, they will get you consumed and devoured by a bully or by somebody who's looking for an opportunity. It's the same thing in leadership. If you don't project confidence, underline project, you don't have to have confidence from inside. I mean, if you have it, that's great, but sometimes you don't have it. But you need to project it. You need to act as if you're confident. And for that, you need to work on yourself, you need self-leadership, you need encouragement, and other stuff. But you need to project confidence in both cases, in the street and when you exercise leadership. Otherwise, you will not make it in both environments. On the street, you need to have what people call emotional intelligence. Some people don't like this term. Bottom line, you need to know how to mingle with the society. You need to know how to blend. You need to know how to become part of the street so that you can be effective. You need to know how to blend. You can't be a tourist in the street. You can be, but you'll be a tourist. The street at least will deal with you as a tourist. But if you want to be an effective member in the street, you know, have business grow, be an entrepreneur, successful, you know, activity, live there and live off the street, then you have to know how to blend. The same thing in leadership. You can't exercise leadership if you don't know how to blend within the environment that you're trying to mobilize. In the street, you cannot be intimidated. You cannot be scared. You can be scared, but at least you can't let being scared paralyze you, because that will finish you. So no space for intimidation. You will be intimidated. Some people will try to intimidate you, but you can't allow this to happen, because you will be making yourself available to their aggression or bullying or competition. Same thing in leadership. You will be facing resistance. You will be facing opposition. You can't be allowing yourself to be intimidated. Otherwise, you give up. So you have to keep moving forward. In the street, you have to back off people sometimes. You have to get people, you know, push people away when they try to infringe or penetrate into your boundaries. And it will happen because, you know, imagine Manhattan, imagine street of India, imagine street of Cairo, of Tehran, of Beirut, of Syria. So imagine all of that. So you need to, when people step into your territory, you have to tell them, back off. And in leadership is the same thing. Because in leadership, you're in the eye of the storm, and people try to step into your territory and sabotage what you're doing. You need to tell them, back off. In the street, you can't give signs of weakness. They will eat you alive, metaphorically speaking. Leadership, the same thing. You can't show signs of weakness. How can you inspire, motivate, mobilize others, give them hope and confidence if you're shaking, if your knees are shaking, at least visibly? So you can't show weakness. In the streets, you have to be aware of risks. So you have to be brilliant in risk taking, very good calculator of risk, because it's a dangerous place. All the streets is it's all about risk, because so many people are there for, you know, for resources, for survival, for opportunities, competition at its highest. Same thing with leadership. It's a very risky enterprise. You need to calculate your risk, and you need to be aware of your risk. In the streets, you need to pick up your fights and make sure that you don't engage in unnecessary conflict. You don't do that in the street. You avoid conflict as much as you possibly can. Some cases, no, you have to go, you know, fight to the finish. And maybe sometimes you have to start the conflict yourself, if it's a survival issue, to defend yourself or your business or your family or your entity. Leadership, you have to do the same thing. You have to pick up your fights, because fighting is costly. Fighting consumes resources. And you might get scratched or damaged or wounded. Same thing. So you only fight the necessary fight. In the streets, you have to know how transparent you want to be. If you're not discreet in the streets, then you become vulnerable to people. And same thing in leadership. You can't just be transparent to everybody and, you know, show all your cards. You have to be smart, you know, politically smart, so that you know what to keep within you and what to expose. And if you want to expose something, you do it at the right time. In the streets, you need to have a plan. When you go in the street in the morning, you have to have a plan. Where you're going, what you're doing, traffic jam, no traffic jam, how do you maneuver, all of that, what do you do, how do you businesses, negotiation, all of that. Same thing in leadership. You need to have plans, and you need to be in the planning process. You need to trust your guts in the street. You need to trust your instinct that has kept you alive through your, you know, human species for generations and generations. Right? So you need to trust your instinct. In leadership, you need to do the same thing. Not everything is rational. Not everything is conscious. So many things are subconscious. And that relates to instinct, to gut. So you need to trust that. So all of these are part of what being in the street is all about. Being smart street, or street, sorry, being street smart is essential to your survival. In the street, if you're in business, if you're an entrepreneur, if you're part of strong competition, you need to be street smart. It's exactly the same thing in leadership. You need to be street smart in terms of practical intelligence. Now, be smart at all level. Be book smart, street smart, conceptually smart, theoretically smart. I mean, if you put the word smart next to it, try to be as smart as possible in every possible way. But because leadership is about dealing with mess, because leadership is about conflict, confusion, uncertainty, fight, competition of ideas, mobilization, rejection, attacks, counterattacks, boundaries, defending boundaries, violating boundaries, all of this is part of the universe of leadership. You need to acquire similar skills, right, that also exist in the streets. Or these are the skills that both being in the surviving the street and exercising leadership share. In the end, it's about having whatever you need to survive and grow in any environment, street or no street, because you have one purpose: to stay alive and to make the best out of your life through growing at all possible levels. For that you need skills, for that you need knowledge, for that you need attitude. So look around you and look at your environment. Whatever it takes so that you can survive and grow, you and people around you, your loved ones, your community, in that environment, acquire those skills. Because it varies from place to place. It varies from condition to condition, from context to context. But you need to have the necessary components. Otherwise, you can't make it. And that's the story of life. Be strong. Because what's the alternative? Be weak? What happens to weak people? Life will break them. That's what happened. Weak means you're vulnerable to being broken. That's what weak means. So that's why my message is be strong, because life favors the strong. Now, when I'm talking about being strong, There's so many ways of being strong. There's intellectual strength, there is, you know, physical strength, there's financial strength, there's strength in, you know, in creativity, there's spiritual strength, there's emotional strength, there's mental strength, there's psychological strength, there is social strength. There's, you name it, there's scientific strength, I mean, you name it. Whatever it is, in any components of life, be strong. Be strong. Non-negotiable. And your survival and growth will depend, and success will depend on how strong you are. So people on the streets or people at home, regardless of your circumstances, if there's one message, is to be strong. You have no other alternative. Because to be strong, it means to live. At least increasing your chances of life. The alternative, you're done.
Thank you for listening to the Michael Kouly podcast. Please visit KoulyInstitute.com and send us an email. We would love to hear your comments and thoughts on this episode. And remember to follow Michael's continuous learning insights on social media.